If you guys need coins to pick up a player for your team, check out Mud Store. Use promo code TOKE for 10% off. Starting to pick up a little bit of a pace here, boys. Welcome back to my week 7 NFL picks. And I'll be honest with you, for a second, I thought I was tanking like my Oakland Raiders. But the good news is the Raiders are on a bye, so us not having to pick them to win could be a potential perfect chance for a perfect week of NFL picks. Now on Thursday Night Football, you already know we nabbed it, baby. Broncos winning, and they wound up winning big. Emmanuel Sanders had an amazing, amazing game, dude. Now, we're going to definitely think we're going to have a perfect week, guys. As always, man, if you enjoy these picks, you can see my record. Leave a comment down below. Let me know if you agree with me or disagree with me. Now, there has been a lot of rumors that if I pick your team to win, that I ultimately jinx them to lose. It really could be a thing. Now, guys, I am recording this a day early, so if, like, someone is out and I don't update you guys in this video, that is the reason why. We got the Titans, man, versus the LA Chargers, and as much as I want to pick the Chargers to lose, I can't ever seem to get the Tennessee Titans right. If I pick them to win, they lose, vice versa. So I figured the Titans potentially could be about a 9-7 team, an 8-8 team, maybe a 10-6 team. They got a couple more L's to go if they're going to get there. So I've got the Chargers winning, which means the Titans are probably going to win. This one's interesting because the Jacksonville Jaguars defense has been exposed multiple times, boys, back-to-back games. And you already know, Bortles, there's no Leonard Fournette, and Carlos Hyde got traded, but I don't think he is going to play today. Jaguars at home against the Houston Texans. A stat I read, the Houston Texans, Deshaun Watson, has had more quarterback pressures with 70 than any other NFL team. You want to know who has the most? Second, I think it's the Cleveland Browns with 42. So Watson, a mobile quarterback, he's definitely getting pounded on, boys. But I am going to go with the Houston Texans against the Jacksonville Jaguars. Carolina Panthers, a lot of really good games today, guys. Absolutely a lot of good games. I'm riding Carson Wentz. I'm going Eagles. Carolina, they've been playing really, really well. But I've got the Eagles at home here. The New York Jets, man. Yo, Jet fans, I'm taking you twice in a row. You've won twice in a row, boys. Today, they're going up against the Minnesota Vikings, who bounced back last week. Kirk Cousins, Adam Thielen is insane, dude. Madden player, like, Adam Thielen should be a 98 overall in Madden. He's like a 92. He is one of the best, if not the best, wide receiver in the NFL right now. Don't at me. It's facts, dude. I've got the Minnesota Vikings. They're going to go ahead and beat the New York Jets at home. Sam Darnold still looks really, really good, though. Patriots at the Chicago Bears. Last week, I picked Tom Brady to win, and he won. And I didn't feel great about it. Today, I'm taking Tom Brady again on the road. Soldier Field. Is it still called Soldier Field? Chicago Bears, man. Khalil Mack, Mitchell Trubisky. They're going to lose today. Tom Brady and the Patriots, another W. Bills at Colts. Colts are one of the worst teams in the NFL, 1-5. Yeah, my Raiders might literally be the worst team, but whatever. I'm man enough to admit it. I would take the Bills here, but no Nathan Peterman, no Josh Allen. I think Derek Anderson last time. I could be wrong. Like I said, guys, I'm recording this a little early, but pretty sure the Bills have a third-string quarterback starting, maybe even someone they just picked up. You gotta ride with Andrew Luck. Don't know if T.Y. Hilton's playing. Don't care. The Colts are winning. Cleveland, I picked y'all last week to win, man. And it hurts me to say that y'all lost. Y'all lost. Baker Mayfield, you guys got to get some wide receivers. And you just traded away your best. Chubb season? It might be Chubb and Baker Mayfield season here. The wide receivers got to catch the football. Baker's putting it right on the money. Unfortunately, with that being said, I got to go Tampa Bay. Jameis Winston had an amazing game last week. Tampa Bay at home over the Browns. I like the Lions. I have picked a lot of sleeper picks for the Lions to win. Matthew Stafford, Golden Tate, the other wide receivers. Then I got the Dolphins tweeting me left and right like, bro, you ever gonna pick the Dolphins? You know what, Dolphin fans? I'm picking y'all today, and I don't want you tweeting me when you lose saying, don't ever pick the Dolphins again. I'm doing you a solid. I have blessed you with my pick. The Dolphins are going to win this game. I hope. Low-key, Dolphins are pretty nice. You know what? I actually, Dolphin fans, I changed my mind. Y'all are losing. I'm going Detroit Lions, baby. Another really good game. Dolphin fans, I'm sorry, but I want to go perfect. I got to go with the boys. I got to go with the Lions. We got the Saints versus the Baltimore Ravens. I think both of them have really good records. I think the Saints only lost once. Maybe the Ravens only lost twice. Could be wrong, guys. Kind of don't have my notes up, but I'm going to go, of course, the New Orleans Saints, man, Alvin Kamara, Michael Thomas, Drew Brees. Like, enough said, though, the Ravens defense is really, really nice. They got to be able to stop completely Drew Brees, Kamara, Ingram. They can only slow them down. I like the New Orleans Saints here. Holy shit, man, Dallas. Dallas dropped 40 on the head of the Jacksonville Jaguars defense. Dak Prescott, Zeke, everyone looked good, man. Now Dallas is going into Washington, who also won last week. Alex Smith, the dump off king, always seems to find a way. With that, I'm going Washington Redskins. Cowboy fans, I'm sorry. I've got the home team here. I got the Redskins, a divisional game, a must-win game. I believe for both teams, maybe a little more for Dallas. But I'm going Washington. Rams at 49ers. Oh, what could have been if the Rams and the 49ers were both extremely healthy? Not saying that I would have taken the 49ers, but I got to continue to ride the train with Todd Gurley, Jared Goff. The Rams are going to win. All right, Bengal fans, it's time to stand up. All right? I know I don't ever pick you, and when I do, you win. That's going to continue today. I'm not picking the Kansas City Chiefs. They lost last week, and they're going to lose today. Andy, the Red Rocket Dalton, and the Cincinnati Bengals go into Arrowhead Stadium, Sunday Night Football, and they shock everyone. Guys, the Chiefs do this every year. They're losing tonight. Andy Dalton, I got him. I'm starting him in fantasy, and everything. That's how confident I am. Maybe because Derek Carr only got me 6 points last week, and he's on a bye. Finally, we got the Giants going into Atlanta. Atlanta has scored so many points, but they've also given up a crazy amount of points, dude. You wouldn't think the Falcons' record is what it is, but injuries have absolutely killed them. Calvin Ridley, I don't know if he's going to play, like I said, but I think he's potentially going to play. It's going to help the Falcons out. Eli Manning has no time to throw the football. Odell Beckham cannot make big plays unless he has time to throw the football. Barkley, on the other hand, dump it off. Give it to him. The dude is a tank, bro. Feed Barkley. Falcons are going to win, though, man. I've got Atlanta at home. Perfect week of picks. God, I hope so, man. Drop a like if you guys enjoyed. Let me know how you feel. And as always, enjoy the games tomorrow with your friends and family. And I will see you later.